Today, Google dropped their brand new Gemini 2.5 native audio models. This is an updated version of their voice-in voice-out model and can be used to build voice agents. So it has been 2 years since the first batch of Gemini models came out, and they have certainly come a long way. In particular, they have been leading in the field of multimodality and multimodal reasoning. You might remember the controversy around Google's apparently faked demo video for Gemini 1.0 Ultra's multimodal capabilities, where the model was made to look like it was given a video stream of a table and reasoning through the video stream to find clues about what was happening, where in reality the frames were carefully selected and it took a lot of prompt engineering to get the result. Fast forwarding 2 years, Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio can do all of this without breaking a sweat. For a very long time now, people have wanted to use these voice agents for interaction because it's so much easier. However, the first iterations that we saw with Gemini 2.0 Flash or GPT Realtime were that, first of all, these models were very expensive to use. Secondly, they were not good at tool use, which meant that although the models were usable for things like chat, you couldn't use them reliably for use cases for the enterprise like customer service agents. But with this new Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio, and especially this new December version that has come out, I found that it's gotten good enough to the point where it can be used to unlock these voice agent use cases. In particular, Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio is much, much better at function calling. In addition, it's much better at instruction following, and it is better and smoother conversations, especially over long contexts. And we see that all of these are very targeted fixes to bottlenecks that have prevented mass deployments of voice agents in the past. If we look at the technical documentation here, we can see that the new Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio model is supporting a bunch of new features. First of all, just like the previous models, it supports inputs of audio, video, and text, with outputs of audio and text. The token limit has been brought out from 32K to 131K. The output token limit is now 8K tokens, and this allows it to use thinking to provide better responses for tough questions. In particular, if we look at the input token count of 131K tokens, doing the rough math of 32 tokens per second on the Gemini API, this roughly translates to around 70 minutes of audio. In my opinion, this should probably be enough to cover even the longest of the customer service calls that you have. Scrolling down, we can see some additional capabilities have been supported with the Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio models. In particular, the native audio part suggests that it can do native audio generation. And because it generates the audio natively and not via a TTS system, it's able to make the audio much more expressive, and it can do things like different tones, read faster, slower, etc. In addition, it supports function calling, and in particular, Google's search grounding tool, which allows the model to provide more up-to-date and grounded responses. We also see that the model is able to think for longer for tougher queries, which allows it to do more complex tasks. In addition, if you're deploying the model in production, the thinking time allows it to think about the user's query and hopefully be a bit more resistant to things like jailbreaking. So now we can dive into the model here on AI Studio, which is Google's officially endorsed platform for trying out these models. So in the inspector here, we can go ahead and select the Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio model. Here we're able to see the pricing. It's 50 cents per million input tokens and $12 per million output tokens. For audio and video, per million input tokens, it'll be $3 and $2 respectively. This is actually the first time I see output costs being cheaper than an input, and I'm not entirely sure why. The knowledge cutoff is in display here, and I'm pretty sure that's a bug. We know with the Gemini 2.5 models, the knowledge cutoff is back in January of 2025. So let's actually go ahead and start talking to the models a little bit here. Gemini, can you hear me properly?
Yes, I can hear you perfectly. Is there anything you needed?
Who are you created by?
I was created by Google.
Okay, that's really cool. Could you tell me a bit about the Gemini model series?
The Gemini models are a series
I'd like to know how they compare to Google's earlier models.
The Gemini models are designed to be more powerful and versatile, capable of understanding and processing various types of information, like text, images, and code, which is a significant difference over earlier models.
That's great. Thanks a lot, Gemini.
Welcome.
So in that demo, we see that we're able to talk back and forth with the model. And using server-side VAD on Google servers, it is able to detect when I start talking, so I'm able to interrupt it. In addition, there's a whole bunch of other settings I can customize here in the inspector. I can change voices, I can change the media resolution to save on tokens, I can turn on turn coverage to make the model much more proactive. We can turn on thinking mode to allow the model to complete much more complex tasks. We can use effective dialogue to exploit the full capabilities of the native audio model. And finally, we can use proactive audio, where basically the model can ignore certain sounds, like a dog barking in the background. So AI Studio is very cool and it's free, and I really recommend everyone try it out here. The thing is, it's a little bit limiting because for advanced use cases like agents, you need to be able to load in your own tools. For example, for a customer service agent, you need to be able to add in tools where the model can look up information about the customer, do web searches, etc. Unfortunately, this cannot be done in AI Studio. So what I did is I used Gemini 3 Pro to vibe code a little demo app here called Genie. And with Genie, I've been able to test out these different use cases. So if we look at the app, we can see that I've built three agents. I built a normal search agent, which is useful for day-to-day tasks. I've built a customer service agent, where it's a fake Apple customer service demo. And I've also built this coding agent, where the model can use tools to update an HTML canvas. Okay, so let's start with the search agent. So the search agent is given two different search tools. It's given the Google search tool, which is low latency, but returns more simple responses. And it's also given the XAI search tools, where it's able to use agentic search, but this might take longer, so it's only used for these complex questions. Okay, let's try this out. Gemini, what is the weather currently in New York?
The current weather in New York, New York, is clear, with a temperature of 30 degrees Fahrenheit minus 1 degree Celsius, and it feels like 25 degrees Fahrenheit minus 4 degrees Celsius.
Can you find out more about GPT 5.2?
I am currently performing comprehensive searches using complex tools to find information about GPT 5.2. I will provide you with the findings as soon as the results are available.
Based on complex searches, GPT 5.2 is OpenAI's latest model released on December 11th, 2025. It's described as the smartest generally available model in the world, offering major advances in real-world knowledge work like coding, spreadsheets, and complex reasoning. Key variants include GPT 5.2 Instant for speed, GPT 5.2 Thinking for expert-level analysis, and GPT 5.2 Pro for tough problems.
To summarize, GPT 5.2 is OpenAI's newest model, launched on December 11th, 2025, and is currently rolling out to users and the API.
We saw in the demo just now that the search agent was really helpful, and was able to automatically determine which type of search tool to use. For the simple queries, it used a low-latency Google search tool where it was able to find the weather in New York. For difficult queries, it was using the GrokD Research API and was able to call that as a tool and use it as results. And an important thing here is to note the difference between these synchronous and asynchronous tools. With asynchronous tools, it might take around 30 seconds to multiple minutes to execute. So what the model did was it was able to chat with me about other things while that tool call ran asynchronously. When the result came back and my conversation with the model on an earlier topic ended, it became idle, and it brought me back to the topic we started with about the search for GPT 5.2. So this is very useful for long-running tasks and solves a lot of the problems people have been having with long-horizon tasks with voice agents. Now let's move on to the customer service demo. Hi there, I recently ordered a new iPhone, but I'm not sure what SKU I actually ordered. Could you look that up for me?
I can certainly help with that. To find your order details, I'll need your customer ID or email address associated with the order.
Okay, my email address is john.appleseed@iPlow.com.
Thank you, John. I'm looking up your order history now. Based on your recent orders, you most recently ordered a MacBook Pro 14-inch M3 Pro on December 7th, 2025. Before that, you purchased an iPhone 15 Pro Max 256 SKU on November 12th, 2025. Is that the one you were referring to?
Yes, exactly. Thanks for reminding me. Hey, looking at the panel here, I actually see that my address is a bit off. So I recently moved down the road to 10 Infinite Loop, Cupertino.
I can update that for you. I'll update your address to 10 Infinite Loop, Cupertino, CA 95014. Is that correct?
Yes, that's perfect.
Your address has been successfully updated. Is there anything else I can assist you with today?
We're good. Thanks a lot for your service.
You're very welcome. Have a great day.
Okay, so here in the customer service demo, we've given it way more tools. It's able to look up information about customers, it's able to edit data, etc. Finally, let's take a look at the coding agent, where I will be able to edit an HTML canvas just by giving voice commands. Okay, so I run a hardware store called John's Hardware Store, and I also repair computers there. Could you create a pretty comprehensive and detailed website for me?
I've created a detailed website structure for John's Hardware Store, covering hardware sales, computer repair, and contact information. You can see it in the preview. Let me know if you'd like to add anything or change anything.
Okay, so this is a bit too black and white, and also I'd like to have more pictures in here. Could you change that?
I've updated the design with a more vibrant color scheme and added placeholder images for the hardware and repair sections to make it more visually appealing. How does this look?
Could you add a section for some mock customer testimonials?
I've added a testimonial section with a couple of mock customer reviews for you, including a link in the navigation bar. How does the page look now?
This looks amazing. Okay, so now I need to revise for Calculus 1. Could you go ahead and create an HTML page with some multiple choice questions in there? I'm looking for somewhere in the range of 5 to 6 questions, and these questions, each of them, should be responsive, where once I click an answer, it should tell me if it was correct or incorrect. Render the mathematical expressions using some JavaScript library.
I have created a Calculus 1 revision quiz page for you. It includes 5 multiple choice questions with interactive feedback when you click an answer, and uses MathJax to render the mathematical expressions. You can test it out in the preview.
Thanks a lot, Gemini. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. Feel free to reach out if you need any more help with web development or anything else.
And here I think we really see the value of having the thinking capabilities in the model. For example, when the model was creating the calculus MCQ practice, it was able to think deeply about the problems and create correct answers, which prior models without thinking would have no shot at. Okay, so that wraps up the agent demos. Overall, I think Gemini 2.5 Flash Native Audio, and in particular this December revision, is very impactful in that it unlocks many of these voice agent use cases because of the addition of thinking, because of the improved long context performance, and also because it's much, much, much better at calling tools. I'm very interested in hearing from everyone what you guys will be building with these new voice models. That'll be it for the video. Thanks a lot for watching. Like and subscribe if you found the video interesting and useful, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.